Yo, yo, what's going on, YouTube? I'm back with another best UAD plugins, and this one's specifically for mixing. I think I did one specifically for vocals and I think bass or something, but I haven't done like overall, you know, mixing basically. So, you know, I pretty much tried to fill up every slot, and to be honest, these are like the main ones that I would use or that I do use. Some of them are specific to UAD2, meaning you do need some UAD hardware like the sound card or their interfaces. Other than that, you know, I've tried to use some UAD native plugins like from their Spark package. So yeah, let's get right into it. And then also real quick before we get into it, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. You know, I'm still trying to get to 1,000 subs, and we're slowly getting there. I get like a couple a day, but you know, it would be nice if everybody could subscribe. Like I said in a previous video, I have a lot of returning people come watch my videos, but they're all unsubscribed. So please subscribe. But anyways, yeah, let's get into it. So the first one is the UA176. This one is a UADX, but also if you own the UAD hardware, you get both. So you can record with it in real time if you'd like to, or you can just use it post for mixing basically. But I really like this one specifically for vocals. It sounds good on bass. I've used it a few times on bass, but vocals for sure, this one is really, really good. I waited a long time to get it, never had the money when it was on sale or whatever, and I didn't want to pay full price because I knew that this goes on sale often. And then one day I think when it went native, it was super, super cheap, so I picked it up. I specifically do like this one for vocals. You know, you can pretty much use it on anything, it seems like. UAD puts out really good demonstration videos, so you can go check those out on their YouTube channel. But yeah, I would definitely pick this up for sure. And like I said, I would try to wait until it goes on sale. The next one, I talk about this a lot. Same thing. This is available for UAD2 or the UADX, aka their Spark, so you can get it natively. Same thing. I would probably wait till it goes on sale. When I had a UAD interface, tracking through it was really nice, especially drums. And then, you know, it's a channel strip, so you got EQ, compressor, gate, filters, and then you got a mic preamp, and then you have a little bit more output or coloration with this fader. There was like a certain point when I first got it that I was like using it on my mix bus. It sounds really cool. The next one is the LA2A, which if you are a returning viewer, you know that I really, really like the LA2A. I recently took it out of my template just because I'm kind of into the Fairchild currently, but you know, I still will add this as another layer of compression if I feel like I'm still not getting what I need out of a vocal. I mostly use this on vocals. It can be used anywhere. You know, all these can be used anywhere. There's really no specific thing. No one's gonna call you out for using this on a fucking snare or something. You know, like use it wherever you want. But where I think that it really shines is definitely vocals. There's like a certain kind of like sheen that it has. There's a little bit of clarity, if that makes sense, that it brings. It really brings vocals forward. It clamps down on vocals in a really nice way, and it doesn't really sound too compressed. You can get it to sound really compressed, but it still sounds really cool. It's very unique in my opinion. You can get all three, the LA2A Silver, which is this one, the LA2A Gray, and the LA2, which is basically the original LA2A. Very slow attack and release, but super, super vintage sounding. But yeah, you can get all three of those with UAD2, but they're also available for UAD Spark. And then this one, I wish it would get an update. This was the first UAD plugin I think I ever bought when I had my original Apollo Twin Thunderbolt 2 Silver. I don't use it anymore because I don't have any UAD hardware currently anymore. But you know, when I did, I definitely used this for mastering. In my opinion, this is a really, really good plugin for mastering. It's definitely not subtle in my opinion. It's very, very aggressive, meaning like you can hear like a dB or a couple dB or 3 dBs. Definitely like you'll hear what it's doing. Whether it's a cut or boost, it's definitely doing a lot. But this is another one that I hope goes native. It probably won't, but I could be wrong. I hope I'm wrong. Because if it does go native, this is definitely going to be something that I will use on my mix bus for sure. I just like the way it sounds. In my opinion, it sounds really clean. I'm not really sure what it's based off of. I don't want to throw out any EQs. I know it's based off of something, or it's supposed to be inspired by something, but I'm not gonna throw any EQs out there because I really genuinely don't know. But yeah, this is another plugin I would pick up. Like I said, if you have UAD hardware, I would consider picking this up. If you're looking for like a really nice, clean, versatile mastering EQ, or just something to throw on your master bus, I would check this out. Like I said, you know, this is, you need the UAD hardware with this. But yeah, another one I would check out. Like I said, only available on UAD 2, so you need hardware for this one. This next one is something that as soon as I saw it and I heard the demonstration video, I definitely was like, oh, I need to get this. Or at least I didn't have any reverb plugins like this. Like, you know, obviously the point of a reverb is to put something in a certain space. But when it's physically modeled off of an actual room, I think having at least one in your reverbs that you use is definitely beneficial. But yeah, this thing sounds like it actually sounds like it's in a room, whatever you send it through. Everybody has the same reverbs, you know, Lexicon, AMS, the Valhalla stuff, like all that stuff sounds great. But yeah, just having something that's modeled after a real room is definitely a must have in my opinion. So yeah, Hitsville, available for both UAD 2 and the UAD Spark. The next one, which I mentioned a second ago, and something that I've talked about this year, is that the Fairchild 660. I don't have a preference on the 670 or the 660. This is just the one I pulled up when I decided to try it, and this is just the one I stuck with. So no real specific reason why. Just long as it's a Fairchild, in my opinion. But yeah, this, you know, was used and can be used on anything, especially this was like one of the original compressors. So Mixbus, I'm pretty sure at some point was used. Maybe not modern music anymore, like hip-hop and stuff. It might be a little too aggressive and a little too slow. The attack and release times might be a little weird. But yeah, you know, you might be able to get it to work. So try it out if you want. But me personally, where I think this shines is vocals. Similar to the LA-2A, like the kind of vibe I'm getting, the kind of tone, the kind of sound that I'm looking for. This Fairchild really enhances it and does it in a much more, I don't know how to say it. I don't want to say better way because it doesn't sound better. It just sounds different. It's just like a different flavor, and I think it sounds really cool. So another one that's available for both UAD 2 and Spark Distressor. I know there's a few out there, but in my opinion, I think the UAD 1 sounds pretty much exactly like the real Distressor, in my opinion. I tried the other ones out. I just didn't like the layout. I didn't like the way they sounded. I think they added their own thing to it, if that makes sense. Like they always add their little things to their plugins. I'm not going to say the companies, but I feel like with UAD, they're like, no, we're just going to make a Distressor. We're not going to add anything to it. We just want it to sound like a Distressor. And I think they did a good job with it. Definitely bass. Vocals, these are, you know, a lot of these are vocal plugins, but you know, especially a Distressor, it's super versatile. If you haven't seen my last video, I did a breakdown of the Distressor, so it's not this last one, it's like a couple videos before this one, so you know, go check it out if you want to hear like real audio examples. But Distressor, get it if it's on sale. Like I said, available for both hardware, UAD2 and Spark. And then this next one is the LA-3A. This I actually only use on bass. It is super popular for bass. I think that's where it shines, in my opinion. Just another compressor that I think sounds really clean. It doesn't overcompress. It can if you want it to overcompress, but it just really clamps onto the signal, or in this case, the bass that I'm referring to. And yeah, I mean, it just sounds really good. Another one that's available on both hardware and Spark. So, but yeah, I was really excited actually when this one went native. I was like, oh hell yeah, like I'm gonna start using this for bass again, which I have been. So at least like bass guitar and stuff like that, 808s, this kind of shits the bed on 808s in my opinion. But any other bass source, any sustained bass especially, this really shines. And then this next one that I'm hoping goes native, I wish it was already native, I'm crossing my fingers hoping that this year or maybe this month, I don't know, that it will go native. This is the SSL e-channel strip. I've talked about this before in other videos. Anytime I get the opportunity to mix through with it or record with it, especially. I'll definitely record through it if I want to, or if I can, or if it makes sense for the song or whatever. Because this sounds really cool. It sounds really clean. I still think between the Plugin Alliance and this one, I would say this one, in my opinion, outshines the Plugin Alliance just by like 5%. And I've talked about it before. It's just because of this transformer button. It really adds like some like analog thing that the Plugin Alliance doesn't do, basically, or doesn't give me. So yeah, I would definitely pick this up if you, especially if you have UAD hardware. I mean, this thing is so versatile. If you have the satellites and you have like extra cores, or you have a 16, you know, Apollo rack where you can have multiple instances of these, I would definitely pick it up, because I only had an Apollo Twin and it was a duo, so I could only use like three of these, I think, or maybe two. Hoping this goes native. As of now, as of this video, this is only for UAD2, which, like I said, you need the hardware for it. And then this last one, same thing. I actually bought them both in a package. I got them on sale, I think, for like, I literally think I got them for like $150 or some shit like that. There was like a sale, and I think I had a coupon. It was around Christmas or Black Friday. I basically just got like the whole package super, super cheap. But like I said, another one that I hope and wish that it would go native. Yeah, one that I would definitely consider picking up is, most likely, I think these come in a package. I think you can buy them individually. I could be wrong, but if not, you get both, so why not have both? Another one I would say, wait, definitely wait till it goes on sale, because the whole package I think is like $400 or $300. It's a lot, but yeah, I would pick this up, especially if you don't have any sort of bus compressor or any solid state bus compressor, SSL, I mean. I would definitely pick this up. But yeah, those are pretty much all the plugins. Super quick, just run through. Like I said, most of these videos, if you watch my other videos, I use a lot of these plugins and I've broken them down, whether it's a session breakdown or something. They're definitely going to be in there. Especially when I used to have an Apollo, I used a lot of the UAD2 plugins. So, anyways, I would check it out. Thanks for tuning in. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Trying to get to 1,000. And yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Peace.